Good morning, students. Firstly, we will recall the chapter, the necklace. We have already read. Ma'am Loisel belongs to a family of clerks. Her existence is quite average. They live on meager income, enough for basic needs, but not to fulfill aspirations. She gets married to a clerk and is so caught up with her dreams of wealth and pleasure that she is out of touch with the truths of the real life. In order to keep up appearances, just to flatter her pride, she blows up 400 francs on a gorgeous dress. And not contented, she goes on borrowing a necklace from her friend, Ma'am Forestier. Her friend, she does not refuse. Displaying her generosity, she opens the entire array of her jewels for Matilda to choose from. She asked her friend to give her the diamond necklace, but she lost the necklace. She and her husband decided to replace the jewel. Loisel possessed 18,000 francs, which his father had left him. He borrowed the rest. He made ruinous promises, took money from usurers and the whole race of lenders. Then he went to get the new necklace, depositing on the merchant's counter 36,000 francs. Now, the husband, he possessed 18,000 francs, and these francs his father had left for him. He borrowed the rest of the money he borrowed. He took money from money lenders. Then he went to get the new necklace. He went to purchase the new necklace and he deposited the money. And what was the amount? The amount was 36,000 francs. When Ma'am Loisel took back the jewels to Ma'am Forestier, the latter said to her in a frigid tone, "You should have returned them to me sooner, for I might have needed them." When Ma'am Loisel, she took back the jewels, she returned the jewels to Ma'am Forestier, she said in a rude way, "You should have returned them to me sooner, for I might have also needed them." Ma'am Forestier did not open the jewel box as Ma'am Loisel feared she would. What would she think if she would perceive the substitution? What should she say? Would she take her for a robber? Ma'am Forestier, she did not open the box, but Ma'am Loisel, she was worried. She was worried. Why? She was worried to think what will happen if she would perceive the substitution. Ma'am Loisel now knew the horrible life of necessity. She did her part, however, completely. Heroically, it was necessary to pay this frightful debt. She would pay it. They sent away the maid. They changed their lodgings. They rented some rooms in an attic. And now their life was quite different. Ma'am Loisel not knew the reality, the horrible life of necessity. She did her part very bravely, as it was necessary to play the part. Why? They have to pay the frightful debt. She would pay it. So they sent away the maid, they changed their rooms, and they rented some rooms in an attic. She learned the odious work of a kitchen. She washed the dishes. She washed the soiled linen. Now she learned the extremely unpleasant work of the kitchen. She washed the dishes. She washed the soiled linen. their clothes and dishcloths, which she hung on the line to dry. And she hung all these clothes in a line to dry. She took down the refuse of to the street each morning and brought up the water, stopping at each landing to catch her breath. Now she took the solid waste that requires collection and transport to a disposal site. She took it to the street each morning and she brought up water, stopping at each landing to catch her breath. As she and clothed like a woman of the people, she went to the grocers, the butchers and the fruiterers with her basket on her arm, shopping, haggling to the last sou of her miserable money. Now, what was his work? Her work was, she went to the grocers, the butchers and the fruiterers with her basket on her arms. And why? She goes there for shopping and she bargain persistently, especially over the cost of something. She tries to bargain to save a small amount of money. The husband worked evenings, putting the books of some merchants in order, and nights he often did copying at 5 sous a page. And husband, he also worked evenings, putting the books of some merchants and in order. The order he received, and nights he often did copying them. And what was the cost of these pages? 5 sous a page. What is the meaning of sous? A small amount of money. And this life lasted for 10 years. And 10 years they lived the same life. At the end of 10 years, they had restored all. And after 10 years, they reached at the stage of re-establishment. So, Mam Loisel seemed old now. What were the changes? Mam Loisel, she seemed old now. She had become a strong, hard woman. And now she was a strong and hard woman, the crude woman of the poor household. She was lacking in sophistication. She was the crude woman of the poor household. Her hair badly dressed, her skirts awry, her hands red, she spoke in a loud tone. So, what was the change? Her hair, they were badly dressed. Her skirts, it was crushed. It was with a turn on the turn, with the turn and twist. Her hands were red, and she spoke in a loud tone and washed the floors with large pails of water. She washed the floors with large pails of water. But sometimes when her husband was at the office, she would seat herself before the window and think of that evening party of former times, of that ball where she was so beautiful and so flattered. And when her husband was at the office, she would sit herself before the window and think of that evening spoiled her life, the evening party of former times, of that function where she was so beautiful and she was the cause to feel honor, cause to feel pleasure. So in this way, there were changes in the life of Mr. and Mam Loisel. They suffered as they missed the necklace.